Today we're going to be talking about the tools that I carry on my bike. Stick around. Hey, this is Chad with Be Gone For Good. We do videos all about adventure motorcycling, from the bikes we ride, the gear that we use, the trips we take, tips, tricks, tutorials, anything under the sun that has to do with adventure motorcycling, you're gonna find it on this channel. If that's the sort of thing that appeals to you, definitely subscribe, hit that bell so you get notifications anytime we release a new video, generally on Fridays. And if you like this particular video, hit the thumbs up, it really helps out the channel. Thank you very much. Today we're gonna be discussing all of the tools that I carry on my bike routinely for trips, for commuting. Some of them are on the bike all the time. Others I kind of mix and match as I have longer trips or different needs going off-road versus roads and how remote we're gonna be versus how in towns and cities we're gonna be. Some of it changes and I'll talk to you about all of those different needs. If you use different tools or think I've missed anything, leave a comment down below so I can add some different items to my mix as well. Let's get started. All right, this is my tool roll, the Mosco Moto Fatty. This is attached to the bike with this strap, maybe sometimes some other straps. It's got this waterproof cover on the outside, which I also use when I'm using the tool roll and lay out this cover, and then all sorts of screws and the pieces and stuff go on top of here. So at least that way, once this is clear, I know I can move the whole thing. In here, I've got a couple of sections of wire, just in case anything needs to be wired together. This will work for connections, and also if I need to just tie something up real easily. If I have a exhaust bolt that breaks, I can loop this through and put that up there. I've got a couple of rubber gloves in here also. I also keep some in my tank bag if I need to have rubber gloves out there just for any reason. Those are all in there. This first pocket, a few different items. I've got some quick weld from JB Weld in there. I've also got some PermaSeal for a radiator leak in there. That like powder stuff that you stick in there and it just kind of seals up the leak, that's in there. I've got a paint marker. I've used this to mark the chain if I made an adjustment, or sometimes the tire if I have any issues with a plug or something along those lines. This will at least give me an indicator of where I need to check it out in the future. Or if I seat a bolt, I'll put a paint marking on there so that I can know whether or not that bolt moves after I've done it. I've got a little bit of Loctite in there. Some chain links, as I'd said, some fast links. And then zip ties. Everybody knows zip ties, loves zip ties. These things will get you out of a billion different types of jams. Between zip ties, wire, and duct tape, I don't think there's any problem that can't be fixed. So that's the first pocket. Second pocket. I've got a Loctite stick. Now this I'm really happy with, because this is something so you don't have to ever worry about this leaking. This isn't gonna ever dry up on you. It's just a stick, almost like a chapstick type of thing. You can rub the bolts in there. Same Loctite, but in a more solid form. I've got my bead buddy in here if I'm making a tire change. This will keep the bead seated so it doesn't keep rolling around the tire on you. I find this is really helpful. I've got the rest of my tire changing stuff in a different area, but the bead buddy just sits in here. I have a Allen wrench key here, or just different Allen wrenches. This is one of them. I've got the other one from the Cruise Tools that I keep in my tank bag. Various other Allen wrenches in here and different sockets available. These are sort of redundant items, as some of this is available on different tools that I keep underneath the seat or in the tank bag as well. So when I pull this out, I can do all the work I need to, but some of those other tools are up there if I need to make quick fixes, things like that. In this big pocket here, I got a little bit more. So I have these. These are something that I just got off of the internet. They have the keys for the two axles on the rear or the front, so that you can get those released. And then various other little wrenches in there and spoke tools, things like that. These have come in really helpful. This is what I use to remove the rear nut from the tire, and they've been perfect in that capacity. Super small, lightweight, but they feel pretty strong. Then I keep a screwdriver that's got a removable head in here, so I can use this for Allen keys. I can use this for screw, for Phillips or flathead, anything along those. Got a bunch of different wrenches, various sizes. I've got a ratchet in here. I've got an X-Acto knife and adjustable jaw in there, and then an extension for any of those ratchets that I need. So all of that goes in here. Then up here in this little mesh section, I've got a couple of the smaller wrenches up here, little tiny things, and another Allen wrench in case I needed a couple extra nuts on there. But pretty simple stuff in this main section. On the back, there's a little pocket here for some more wrenches and spoons. So I've got a couple of tire spoons back here. These ones are aluminum, so they're super lightweight and just extra. So I have the ones that I keep under the seat, which are iron or steel, I guess. And these ones are aluminum. And between the four of those, me and a buddy should be able to get basically any tire off. If you notice, I've wrapped this with duct tape around here if I need any duct tape, and then wire, really, really tight wire on there. Just in case I need any wire, I can pull these out, strip that wire off, and then I can use the wire for whatever that that need is. And that's everything in the Fatty tool roll. That's my whole toolkit. Anytime I am working on the bike, this is the kit that comes out and this is what I work with. If there's anything that I need during the course of that project, it then goes back into this toolkit so that I have everything that I need for standard maintenance. Any reasonable fixes on the bike come from here. Obviously, this isn't a comprehensive, this can't do everything for the bike, but anything that will get me up and moving should be found in this tool roll. And if it's not, I'll figure that out through kind of guessing and testing and working on the bike over time. And it should be better and better each time I bring it out. Up next, I have the rest of my tire changing kit. This all exists underneath the seat. So I've got my bead breaker spoons and obviously the bead breaker element. This is from Motion Pro. These are a little bit more expensive than just standard spoons, but this bead breaker capability is really awesome. They're wrapped in duct tape again. So if I need any extra duct tape, it's available to me right there. This all sits under the seat, so it never comes off the bike. Also under the seat is my tire repair kit. Now, this is a kit that had a lot of stuff in it to begin with. A lot of stuff that I don't necessarily even need also because I run tubes, but just in case somebody else in the group has an issue, I've got a lot of stuff here that can be utilized for that. From a valve core remover, I've got a bunch of valve cores in here, extra caps, just standard stuff that you might need for a tire change. Then I've got a stem puller, another valve core remover, just various items that are gonna be needed sometimes in here, and it all sits in this kit. Then you've got your patch kit stuff, all your stuff to refill tubes, to seat beads, you know, your plug kit, all of that stuff is in here. Again, and it's not something that I necessarily need, but somebody in the group might need it. And again, obviously if somebody in the group is broken down, then I'm not going very far either. So I keep this kit on the bike to make sure that if we have an issue and it's something that can be resolved, that I've got the stuff necessary to make that fix for essentially any problem that happens with a tire or a tube, or if we need a patch, it's all here in this kit. We can get the tire removed, we can get the tube taken care of, we can get the tire taken care of and get back on the road as quickly as possible. Also, a part of that
fixing tires kit is going to be this. This is the cycle pump air pump. This sits underneath my pillion seat. So this is really well covered up because I don't use it too often. And I figure if I ever do need to bring this out, all the luggage is gonna be coming off anyway, but it's a really simple air pump. Everything in there that you need, you can attach this to the battery. It cycles the pump, pumps your tire up, gets you any air that you need. I don't air up and air down for various different environments because it seems kind of pointless to me for the type of riding that I do. But you could do that with something like this also. If you keep it a little bit more readily available, you could air down over some off-road sections and then air back up as you get back on the road. It's super simple to easy to use. I've used it before to fill up the tire just to see how it works. And it's great. Sometimes it overheats a little bit, but as long as you keep aware of it and don't necessarily smother it, you should be just fine.
I also carry 550 cord attached to the bike at all times for fire starting, lifting, you can tie down things, anything that you need a little extra cord for, this is the stuff that'll do it.
I have this Motion Pro toolkit. This sits in my tank bag right near the front. This is just kind of a real quick and easy multi-tool setup that allows you different nuts that you can move. It's got different bits in here that you can attach and utilize to screw in elements that you have. It's just a nice all-round multi-tool for various different things that you're going to be needing to fix on the bike, and there's a ton of different ways that you can utilize it. I have a link down below if you want to take a little closer look at what tools it has, but it's just an everything needed for quick fixes. If you need to torque something up or whatever, you'll find all that stuff in here. I also keep this in here for like a little axle tool. I use this a lot more with my CB500X. And again, it's not necessarily worthwhile on my current bike, but it might be for somebody else's bike that we're running across. And if they're stopped, then I'm stopped. So I keep as much in here that I can to help everybody out in the hopes that we can get back on the road as quickly as possible if we do have a break. I also have a Leatherman that I keep in my tank bag. This is a pretty simple one. Got my pliers there. Obviously it's got a blade in there, various different kind of sanding and cutting tools. It's your standard Leatherman, nothing really amazing with it, but has come in handy a couple of times if I needed to cut something open or to take some zip ties off, or I use probably the pliers more than anything else. They are spring loaded, so it just automatically opens, which makes it really easy to use. This is the way that I twist any wire that I have on the bike. If I'm gonna be using that, I use these pliers for it. This is readily available at a moment's notice inside the bike, so this is one of the tools I use most often for all the simple jobs. Up next, got straps. Everybody has to have straps. I've got a ton of different straps on there. I've got Moscow Moto straps. I've got these type of retention straps on there from Voil. I've got other ones that have kind of carabiners on them and different, all sorts of different straps. Straps for everything you could possibly need. I find this is one of those great things to have along with you. And just in case luggage breaks or you get a clip that comes loose, you can always strap it up with extra stuff. If you have anything else that you get along the trail or anything that you want to buy to take it back to camp, you can always use these extra straps to make that happen. Now, I know it's not necessarily a maintenance item, but it is the sort of thing that can really end a trip early if you're not paying attention, but I keep a trauma kit with me. Now, sometimes I'll also carry a first aid kit, which just has, you know, like moleskin and Band-Aids and calamine lotion and burn relief and stuff like that. But this is a little bit more heavy duty. Obviously you've got your trauma shears here. This has chest seals in here. This has ACE bandages. This has a tourniquet. This is for the day ending wrecks or possibly even life ending wrecks. This is to make sure that if there's any serious injury that takes place on the trail, we have the best shot at getting it taken care of ourselves before medical personnel can get there. This is, when this bag comes out, just all hell's broken loose. It is the worst day that we've had on the trail yet. So that's what this is for. It's real simple to just strap to the outside of the bag. When I'm not traveling, this goes into whatever vehicle I'm using. This one is always with me whenever we're out and about amongst other people, because this will be a lifesaver if it ever needs to come out. I also carry a jump kit in my bag. I've used this a bunch of different times for myself and for others. It's from MicroStart. It's really, from Anti-Gravity Batteries. This is a really great device that you can charge up. And if you just want to charge your phone or different accessories, it also works really well for that. But if you do need to jump the bike, you get this out, you get these little clips out, and you can get the bike jumped with just this little pack. And I'll tell you, it's so much easier than trying to jump bike to bike or waiting for some other measure of assistance. Is this little pack will take care of everything you need with just a real quick charge. Again, worst case scenario, you can also use this as a battery for your other, obviously less important devices, but it also will jump your bike at any time that you need it. And for that, it's absolutely worthwhile having on the bike all the time. I always carry a flashlight with me. Sometimes repairs are gonna be taking place at night. Sometimes you just need to see some of those dark corners of the bike. This is a great option to be able to make that happen. It's also got a little switch on the backside, so if I need to signal anybody, I can make that happen really fast. It's just a great all-round multi-tool that you can have and use pretty much anywhere. If my headlamp goes out, this is my fail-safe to make sure that I can operate around camp in the dark. It's just a great item to have. It sits in my tank bag all the time, and I love it. On longer trips, I'll also be known to carry tubes with me. Obviously, this is just in the event that I have kind of a catastrophic loss with whatever my tube is. This is enough to get me going to the next stop where I can get a legitimate fit for a tube and take care of whatever tire issues I have. It's basically just to get you off the trail and back to civilization. So I keep tubes with me on some of the longer, more off-road, more aggressive type trips. If we are close enough to civilization all the way through, I may skip this just to not have to deal with the size and the weight. But if we are gonna be away from major towns and cities for any amount of time, these will always be included in my gear. I also include Cruise Tools Outback M14 in there. I got this from the BDR donation bag. It's got a bunch of different Allen wrenches in there and different screwdriver heads, even a driver in there for different metric ratchet heads. All this stuff is in there. Nice and easy to get to. This stays in my tank bag so I can access it whenever I need to. Really good quality tool. All right, that's everything I have for my toolkit. If you have any suggestions, ideas of things I can drop or add to my toolkit, leave a comment down below. I'm very interested in always improving what I take along with me on the route. If you have any other questions for me, also leave a comment down below. Again, this is Chad with Be Gone for Good. We do videos all about adventure motorcycling. If you like that sort of thing, subscribe to the channel. We put out videos generally once, twice a week, all sorts of different stuff. We got a ton of great things coming up for 2021 in our year of training. We're going to be doing the bourbon run a little bit later and a bunch of other items in there as well. I hope you'll come along with us for the ride. And remember, please, always, the adventure starts with you up here and in here. Thank you again. Ride safe out there.